since of late, I've really started working with a client who specializes in Sri Lankan food. So it's been fun. It's been a challenge.
Because I suppose if you take shots like that, then you'll encounter the problem which Jason just spoke of.
Yeah. Like for example, the chicken shot that we did, just like a leg of a chicken. That looks simply amazing. But I mean, if I was to shoot something, I would just shoot it out of the bowl. And that's not going to work. What made you think, like, okay, maybe I just take out this and maybe put a bit of curry, that way they would know this is what the chicken would look like?
See, it's like this, Jason. If you're doing a curry shot, you have to think about the outside colors as well.
Okay.
So your DOF, as you were saying, it might work with, like, okay, fine, because serving the food on a plate, you do it on a lotus leaf, so you have a little bit of green also on the side.
Very interesting.
I knew that. I was just testing him. That's all I did.
To the viewers' benefit, is it?
All right. Post-work is very important when it comes to digital photography these days. Would you ever, do you ever change, like, how the photo looks, like, on your computer? Or would you, slightly straight out of the camera and just kind of...
Slightly, I would do like color balance, which is basic one. But I don't like to touch up a lot of, like, even like the stains on a plate. I don't want to do that because it doesn't give the natural look.
Right.
Unless it's like,
it's too perfect.
Exactly.
Right.
When it comes to food photography, you want the little imperfect things, like the little like if you're having bread, like the crust a little bit.
Right.
It gives a story behind it rather than just having a slice of bread or something like that.
Right. Interesting that you should mention this. Okay, this is a quick fun thing that I've noticed about a lot of places in Sri Lanka. The photos look phenomenal. Like, for example, if you take a well-recognized fast food restaurant here, and you go there, and you're like, I'd like one of those, please. And you get it, the picture makes it look amazing. And you get it, it looks just like smaller than what it actually is. Does that ever kind of scare you? Like, maybe you might oversell what this dish looks like in your picture because you kind of mess around with like the layout of how this is placed on a plate,
the proportions and stuff.
Well, it's always an argument I have with the chef. You need to photograph what you serve,
right?
Or else sometimes, like, if I have to garnish maybe we'll say a chocolate cookie, right? It's brown, right? You have no other color. So maybe like put a strawberry on top or a cherry. Then you put a mint leaf or something. It gives a little bit of colors as well. So when someone sees it, they have to have the same thing at the restaurant.
Right.
Or else people are going to question saying, you know, it looks different.
Yeah, it's maybe they should just take a photo with me eating the cookie. That way I come with the cookie when you buy it.
And what makes you think people want that, Jason?
I was hoping that they would bring their first one.
I'll buy it for you, don't worry.
Okay. Yay.
I'll buy it.
Cookie and Jason. Cookie and Jason for the win.
No, I'll buy it. I'll take the cookie. I'll take some cookie.
You can keep the Jason.
You can keep the Jason. Dion, it's quite interesting that you mentioned the fact that you actually work with a lot of these chefs. How is it like working with these chefs? Especially when you're trying to, you know, get... I know you would have, like, okay, this idea, this creative input which you want to put, and then it just takes one or two absurd opinions to, like, ruin the thought process.
Or just the regular opinion. Because, like, I understand a lot of chefs, with all due respect, everyone has an ego. But when it comes to people that you're messing around with their art, they'll be like, no, you can't change this. But how do you handle that?
Most of the chefs that I've worked
with... We're not going to mention the restaurants.
Yeah.
Most of the chefs have been really helpful. I mean, they've cooperated really well. But there have been instances that I've... listen, I can't work with these guys because it's really difficult. For example, about 2 weeks ago, I had a shoot with a client where the guy it was a steak, but the chef wanted me to focus on the mushroom on the side because that was the garnish. So there was a massive argument there. But yeah, I just took a shot just to please him.
What was this argument like? Give us a demonstration.
It went on for about an hour.
But at the end of the day, I'm guessing the clients were all satisfied with the photos that you take. At the end of the day, it's how you please them and not the chef, I'm guessing, if I am correct. Unless the chef is the client.
Well, they play that role, you know. But most of the time, I sit with the client as well as the chef during the initial meeting. Then we discuss, okay, these are the plates that we want to photograph.
Right.
And then we go, okay, fine, I need to see them. If you even have like a picture of a phone,
then I
can picture it in my head, okay, listen, this is what I need to bring for the shoot. But it's mainly to please the client, not the chef.
Right.
I see.
Interesting.
Great. You were also a graphic designer profession, right?
Correct.
So this must also help you a lot with your work.
It does. But I started photography way before I started graphics.
Okay.
So now it goes hand in hand together.
So I believe you're also the head designer at a reputed firm.
Correct.
Or company. And so in your role as head designer, are you more into graphic designing or photography?
Both together. As I said earlier, it's always a package that goes together. So when I pitch to a client, I like to go and pitch to hotels, restaurants, and stuff like that. Because every day, like in Sri Lanka, I think restaurants have a lot of scope. And every day, if you look at Colombo, every week there's a new restaurant somewhere. So people need that, you know, exposure.
Wow. Great. So you also said that there was a book which you were doing for one of your projects.
Yeah, this is not food photography, I'm guessing.
No, it wasn't. It was for my final year of my degree.
Right.
It was a book on the people of PETA.
Okay.
So basically the brief said we need to do something on our own, like any brief that we can select. So I chose a photography because it was much easier, like I was more close to it.
Mm-hmm.
So I wanted to do something different. It was a black and white coffee table book of different personalities in PETA. So maybe it might be the juice maker to the jewelry seller to some like a caps or something like that.
Right. That's so interesting.
Oh,
yeah, Dihan, dude, this is like, I really don't know how to say thank you, but I also don't like you because you showed us so much of good food right now. And I'm like, oh man, I'm so hungry. What am I going to do? You know what the best thing is though? It is the morning. And we can just rush off to any place we want.
Yes.
The day is on.
And like Dihan said, in Colombo, we have so many options, you know? And but you know, I mean, especially with all the fancy food that you get out there, at the end of the day, sometimes in the evening, all you want to do is go out there and get a cocktail, right?
That is, oh my god, cocktail.
Yes.
Thanks for mentioning that, by the way. Again, thank you so much. Dude. It's
worth it. So
like, no,
thank you.
let's keep it in. But really, no, thank you. No. Thank you so much for being on the show. It's
no
such
problem.
A pleasure. We really appreciate it when photographers come and share what it is like to be in the business, because it is still an up-and-coming field that people, like a lot of young students today, are afraid to get into because they're like, oh, we can't really make a living. But living proof right here that there is a possibility of making it.
Yep. And also, if you want to check out Dihan's work, you can log on to Facebook and search for Dihan Da Silva. Dihan Da Silva Photography, right?
Yeah.
Dihan Da Silva Photography, and he's got a Facebook page. You can check out his portfolio. And also, if you do have, any restaurant owners out there, if you do have work, maybe you can contact Dihan.
Yeah, do hit him up. That's right. Search for the keywords Dihan Da Silva
Photography
on Facebook. Also, email us at mtvsports@maharaja.ok if you have any information about today's show. Upcoming next, we have the Om Space. Ooh, Serena Burgess on the show here on Good Morning Sri Lanka right after this break.